We greet on behalf of the Portuguese Council for Peace and Cooperation all the organizations present and all who are here defending and enacting the globalization of the fight for peace. We thank the Belgrade Forum for a World of Equals, the organization of this important conference, and their very keen reception of all of us here. We are in Belgrade, where the interference and aggression of NATO are well known by the people of Yugoslavia, who 15 years ago were NATO's direct victims, like we could see yesterday in the photographic exhibition on humanitarian, economic, and the environmental consequences of NATO aggression. An aggression that brought war back to Europe and marked the beginning of a new period of increased aggressiveness of the United States and its NATO allies, who continued with aggressions against the peoples of Iraq, Afghanistan, Libya, Syria, to give just a few examples. But in 1999, NATO already had a long story of interference and aggression, fulfilling its aim of placing Western Europe under United States hegemony and to prevent any progressive transformation in NATO member countries, even resorting to terrorist attacks and operation as Gladio, operation in Italy, that has been denounced by the Italian courts. In Portugal, during the April Revolution, who started in April 25, 1947, NATO exerted pressure and interference of various kinds, including demonstrations of force with the Look the Gate maneuvers, conducted in early 1975 on the Portuguese coast in order to try counteract the progressive course proclaimed by the people and the military of the Revolutionary Armed Force Movement. Hostility to the Portuguese Revolution that contrasts strikingly with the support that was given to the Portuguese fascist regime that oppressed and murdered the Portuguese people and developed a criminal war against the peoples of Angola, Mozambique, Guinea-Bissau, and Cape Verde. NATO, at this summit held in Lisbon on November 2010, adopted a strategic concept reaffirmed in 2012 in Chicago with the aim of strengthening this political military bloc as an instrument of interference and aggression. This was a new qualitative leap, which is the most serious and significant threat to security and peace to the world, as really is showing. With this new strategic concept, NATO is boosting the right of interference and intervention anywhere in the world, on any pretext, advancing with the formulation of so-called new threats as their real purpose in an attempt to justification for its existence and its criminal action. NATO reaffirms in its strategic doctrine the maintenance and use of nuclear weapons, even in a first strike, insisting on the maintenance of the installation of United States nuclear weapons in the territory of other member countries. NATO adopts as its own the United States project for the installation of new offensive missile systems in Europe. A central component of this system is already installed at the Rota base in Spain, with the recent arrival of the first boat of the Aegis system. NATO reaffirmed its intention to extend its sphere of action when possible with the establishment of so-called partnership with countries, regional and international organizations, with variable contact, form and duration to allow their presence and direct action or placing others in the service of implementing its strategy of domain. Thus, NATO would play the role of director and central actor or director of other players according to their needs. To this end, NATO aims to instrumentalities the United Nations to whitewash their illegal actions. And when they do not achieve this, they do not reject the total disregard of the United Nations Charter and international law. In summary, the new NATO strategic concept is a declaration of war on all the peoples of the world. In this context, the European Union reaffirmed itself as NATO's European pillar and its strategic partner, underlining the content and meaning of the Lisbon Treaty for the effective realization of their harmonizing objectives. The new NATO strategic concept once again put in evidence that despite the existence of contradictions between growing powers of the European Union and the United States, their relationship has been guided by a strategic consensus within a framework of subordination of the first to the hegemonic logic of the second. The European Union has been supporting and integrating in an increasingly blatant manner the militarism and interventionist drift of the United States and NATO, participating by assisting and even replacing NATO in its aggression and occupation of sovereign countries. We live in times of great aggressiveness of imperialism, aggressions against Syria, against Mali and Central Africa Republic, or the destabilization of Ukraine are examples of this. Faced with serious threats to world peace and the growing interference and aggression of imperialism, peoples resist with rising strength, vast opportunity to expand and strengthen the resistance come to light generating forces and protagonism of building a better future. The World Peace Council is an integral part of this wide meeting of minds and combative action and will be so much more the more daring, diverse, strong and determinate our intervention. We argue that the struggle for peace is an integral and necessary condition for justice and social progress. We argue that globalizing the struggle for peace passes necessarily through the promotion of a broad anti-imperialist front, defending and strengthening the worldwide movement embodied by the World Peace Council with its anti-imperialist, democratic, unitaire, and mass characteristics. It's a crucial contribution to promote the values of peace, cooperation, and solidarity, and to build a world of progress, peace, and sovereignty. Thank you very much, and good luck for you.